Hi guys, good morning. It is bright and sunny at the moment as the rain has just stopped. It has been so wet this morning. It's been a bit like a biblical flood. But the sun has now come out, and today I'm heading off to try for the very first time a Canadian dish called Poutine. I'm a bit afraid to pronounce it because it's either a very rude word or it's a Russian autocrat, and I'm not too sure which. But hopefully my friend Chantal, who comes from Canada, is going to enlighten me. And that's one of the wonderful things about living in Kigali. Is Kigali is a pretty multicultural place. You've got Lebanese community, you've got Indian community, Korean, Japanese, Italian. You have people from all over the world here, and some great restaurants. So, you know, it's not like I left behind my British culture and came to learn Rwandan culture. I came here and I've learned about loads of different cultures, and especially their food. But this is one that I've never tried before. So, I mean, as I say, I don't know if it's just a Quebecois dish or if it's from the whole of Canada. So I shall ask her. But my friend was really, really excited because we've got a fast food restaurant here called Mr. Chips. I've never actually been there, so this is a double first for me, but I have ordered burgers from there and they're pretty good. But yeah, she went there the other week and she saw that they had poutine on the menu, and she got really excited and she called around and she's like, right, we've got to go and eat this. So I'm like, okay, let's try it. As far as I know, it's something to do with chips. Possibly something to do with cheese, not entirely sure, but looking forward to trying it. So let's go. Okay, so how do you pronounce this word?
Yeah, Poutine.
Poutine, as in President Putin. Putin. Okay.
Yes, but no relation.
All right. Fabulous. One, two, three. Yeah.
Okay. Marion's only invited if she doesn't bring her phone.
Thank you so much. Oh, what is this?
It's like beef gravy.
All right. What is it? Explain what it is.
It is very. And it's homemade here, beef gravy.
So it's chips with beef gravy and cheese, that's it?
Yes. So in Quebec, this would be cheese curds. I don't know if anyone's familiar with what those are. But it's like unseasoned cheese.
Is that like cottage cheese?
No. It's very firm. So it's different than this, but the taste is right.
Okay. All right. I'm on a mission. Okay, right. But this is just normal Rwandan cheese, isn't it? It's not.
He has it made specially.
Okay, so it's. Okay, right. Bon app! Oh, good.
So it's not Gouda, that's what I'm saying.
Okay, so when I lived in Cardiff, there was a place called Chip Alley, and when all of the nightclubs closed at about like 3 a.m., everybody went to Chip Alley, and they literally got cheesy chips with curry, and that's what everybody would eat. So it's like that. But with gravy. That's good.
And it's definitely an after bars closed kind of dish.
Mm-hmm. And is it a Quebecois dish or is it all of Canada?
Now it's all over Canada. When I was a kid, you couldn't get it outside of Quebec.
Oh, nice. All right. I like it.
A little Quebecois history there. Yeah.
How many Canadians are in Rwanda?
I don't know because I've met very few.
Have Rwandan content on your YouTube channel because I never do anything like that. So at least someone will let me know what's going on over there.
So this is an ice cream sandwich. Okay. Thank you.
This isn't the thing where you come from?
Chalk ice is where I come from. Ice cream sandwich, not so much. I would assume it being a wafer. But
my parents used to have boxes of these in the freezer all the time.
No, I've never seen one before. It looks like a frozen giant Oreo, I guess. And I only know what an Oreo is since I came to Rwanda. I've never seen those in the UK. Yeah.
Those are definitely common in the wild of Canada too.
In the wild.
It's absolutely solid.
Thank you. Yeah. You can't bite into this.
Give it a moment.
It's a little bit.
What do you season these?